Hello everybody, feel very welcome to Usitility. Well, we are going to discover how to play Subway Surfers on your PC. Here you can watch it on your screen. We will be able to simply download and set up Subway Surfers and enjoy playing your game on the Windows PC with gamer keyboard if we want to, mouse and big screen. So without further ado, let's get to it. First of all mates, the first thing to do is to open our favorite web browser. We selected the one we prefer. Let's go to that URL that I'm highlighting in green. Now, you are able to see on the screen of the PC. You don't need to type it, because there's the link in the description of this video and as well in the first main comment. We landed right here on our Usitility site, where we have a comprehensive description on how to download and install Subway Surfers on PC. We scroll down a bit as well as click on the Download Game on PC button. After clicking on this link, we get to the website of LDPlayer. No panic, it is only the Android emulator that we will launch to enjoy the game Subway Surfers on PC. It is now obvious that we have a great deal of advantages of preferring using that emulator: custom controls, multiple instances, instance synchronization, macros, scripts, high FPS, and so on. Then, we are ready to proceed to download the Subway Surfers by clicking on the button Download Subway Surfers on PC that I have marked in green. We then click on it. And the download action starts and ends immediately. Here it is, this is the download. It is an executable file. The following step is to launch the installer, so we click on the file. If we are on Windows 10, it will have asked us for permission to make changes to the computer. We answered yes. I reduced the internet browser to view the installer significantly better. The installer is very simple to use. It includes two choices: install and setup path. I will clarify what setup path truly does. We simply click on it. And now we note that we have now here the path where your emulator is going to be placed. If we desire to vary this directory, we need to click on this browse button, so we select another folder and set up the emulator exactly where we like. I prefer to set it by default. I simply click on back. So I simply click install. Right now, before beginning installing that emulator, it's possible that it'll present us several software offers to set up on our desktop. As I do not wish to have any of those computer software, I just simply press each time on the reject button. Voila! The setup begins and it's going to move forward along with the download of these MB that are shown on that screen. The moment you download it, it is likely to be more or less megabytes. The data transfer rate can be at a higher speed or slower, based on your type of connection and depending on the velocity of the emulator servers. Immediately they're running quite fast. The download has been completed, and so at this time it continues with the setup part. The installation is going to take more or less time according to the power of your PC. The more efficient it really is, the faster the software setup time and vice versa. If we add together the download and software setup stage, it can take quite a while, so have patience. It has already finished for me. At this moment, the emulator happens to be launched immediately. As you can observe, down here, there's a progress bar that will fill up then when it gets to the finish, the emulator will be launched for the very first time. The truth is the emulator was already launched, here for the first time. Then LD Store is immediately launched, that is a kind of Google Play. That isn't the optimal technique to install the game, so I do not endorse it, since oftentimes the LD Store puts an out-of-date version of the game app. Allow me to reveal how to set up the video game making use of the Google Play, and therefore I recommend you to do it this way. The very first thing we have to accomplish is to navigate to the desktop by simply clicking on this icon that I'm pointing out in green. Before we carry on, as you can see now, it made two software icons right here on the PC desktop. The LDPlayer and LD Multiplayer. Note that the LDPlayer software icon is the one we are interested in. Anytime we choose to start Subway Surfers on the PC, we twice mouse click on this specific icon and as a result use the emulator. The LD Multiplayer icon is not about multiplayer or anything at all like that. The truth is, it is an icon that we may probably never ever make use of. Why don't we perform the following step, that is a requirement, and which is to entry the Google Play Store. To do that we will go here to System Apps, we click. And we will simply click on Play Store. As you can observe, the Google Play has started. Right here we must sign in. At this time, as soon as we are there, we have to perform the following step, which is obligatory. Therefore we click on Sign In. At this moment it shows Checking Info. It may in some cases get blocked in Checking Info, additionally it doesn't advance. If that's the case, you could try to log in and after a couple of hours and it may most certainly be solved. At this moment we're going to insert our email and password. The email has to be a Gmail email address and its related password. For instance, you can use the very same email you're using at this moment in your YouTube account. Then I will type in my data and I will revisit when I have done it. That's all, details inserted. And here is Google welcoming us and providing us their terms of service. We should accept them simply by clicking on, I agree. Following, it make us possible to backup to the Google Cloud. You could let it selected and it'll make a backup of the files on this device to Google Drive. I will not check it, you can make use of that feature if you prefer. We simply click on accept. From now Google Play is started as favorite choice and immediately. When the Google Play just isn't launched instantly and you do not know how to launch it by hand, I assist you how to do so. The very first thing is to proceed to the emulator desktop by simply clicking on this icon noted in green color. At present we head to the system apps folder. And we click the Play Store icon. Fine, we are there within Google Play. What we are going to accomplish now is browse here to search for apps and games. So we are going to do a search for Subway Surfers. Now there we end up with it, we should click the very first result. Right here we have got the video game. Let's quickly press right here on the install option that I am just highlighting now in green. Therefore it will commence the setup. At present it should install the game app, it may take some time or it could be amazingly quickly. This all is subject to on our own web connection. This has by then ended installing. Back to the emulator desktop by pressing this particular button that I'm showing in green, to be able to start Subway Surfers for the first time. We're now on the emulator desktop, and therefore we are about to click this brand new Subway Surfers icon that's been generated. This video game is launched for the first time. Now there we get it, I'm able to press anywhere on the screen and also make use of the keyboard. I should discuss the volume level of this emulator. It's right here. We have the icon of higher volume as well as the icon of lower volume, this way we won't rely on the Windows volume to increase or decrease the music of the emulator. As well as to take pleasure in the experience to the max, we could switch on the large monitor, for which we have two choices. That is actually the first one, we just click on this particular software icon that I'm pointing out in green. Then the monitor is maximized, coming with one border at the top, one at the right and the last one at the bottom. Assuming that we would like to experience the video game in full screen, we press on this application icon. And then we would likely at present be experiencing the game app in 100% screen mode. To quit the full screen mode, push the F11 key. And we might at present end up being in regular display mode. At this moment I am choosing to present you the computer keyboard mapping that is definitely extremely helpful. This means we may be able to operate the video game far more effortlessly. The first task is to press this application icon, and here you will be able to get the required configuration settings. I can keep the standard configuration, but if you prefer to change this, you can also do so without having problem. I just take this occasion to comment that occasionally, when commencing the Android game a black screen comes out, if this is like this and you notice the black screen and that emulator doesn't initiate, I suggest a achievable technique. We should browse here, to the cogwheel. Within the emulator options, in the advanced choice we get lots of graphic resolutions. This is the pixel quality that we have presently picked by default and so we should select any of these additional resolutions, for example this particular one here. We pick it and after that click on save. It may require us to restart that emulator and once restarted, most likely the emulator will start and that black screen will be completely removed. Clearly, the emulator is entirely in our language. Occasionally it happens that your emulator is launched in the improper language, for example, in Chinese language. And therefore to place it in the correct language we browse here to the cogwheel. Then there inside of additional options, we mouse click on the language drop down. We can also go for the language we want, Spanish, Japanese, etc. After the language is selected, we are going to save, the emulator will restart, as well as the game application, next time we launch it, would as well be in the chosen language. At this point, there's another element that we will need to take into account, and it's that we will receive an email saying that a brand new machine has been connected to this Google account. It is going to check with us if we're the ones who have associated with that electronic device. That's right, we should not get worried, considering that the emulator is simulating an Android electronic device. In order to find which electronic device is being emulated, we return right here, to the cogwheel and we simply click on it. And so we go here to the model choice. And right here we notice that the emulator is behaving like a Samsung mobile phone. And so we're going to receive an email saying that a new Samsung device has been connected to our Google account. That's all, folks, so much for that training. I anticipate you enjoyed it, particularly that everyone found it helpful. In that case, give it a superb like, subscribe, and any comments, requests or ideas, put them in the comment box below. You can even comment things on my Twitch channel. I do live streams every once in a while. You have it listed below in the video description and in the very first pinned comment. Just click on any of those instructional videos that are showing up on the computer screen, and let's have fun again in the future training videos. Bye.